The clash between two of the president's men heats up as Defense Secretary Delfin Lorenzana rejects the arguments of Foreign Secretary Teddy Boy Loxin about the 1951 Mutual Defense Treaty, or MDT. The MDT states the Philippines and the United States will come to each other's aid in case of armed attacks. Lorenzana is seeking a review of the MDT. He contradicts Loxin's argument that the vagueness of the MDT will serve as a deterrent to attacks against the Philippines. In a joint press conference with U.S. Secretary Mike Pompeo Friday, March 1, Loxin said, "In vagueness lies the best deterrence." Pompeo assured Filipinos that any armed attack on any Philippine forces in the South China Sea will trigger mutual defense obligations under our mutual defense treaty. But Lorenzana says the Philippines is not in a conflict with anyone and will not be at war with anyone in the future. "It is not the lack of reassurance that worries me. It is being involved in a war that we do not seek and do not want." Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo says the bongo shirts supposedly distributed at the National Liga ng Mga Barangay event were not authorized to be purchased. Anyo admits issuing a memorandum authorizing local officials to spend government funds for their participation in the Liga's National Assembly in Manila, but not for campaign materials. Opposition Senatorial Bet Gary Alejano earlier sent media documents showing the DALG allowed the use of local funds for the registration fee and kits of the event. The kits allegedly includes polo shirts with Bongo's cartoonized face and logo. Meanwhile, Davao City Mayor and Hugpong ng Pagbabago campaign manager Sara Duterte expresses confidence that GO would not have paid for the t-shirts with government funding.
"I think it should be answered by the senator candidate Bongo, and he should provide details on the paper trail of the expenses for the t-shirts, and I'm sure he can provide that."
Venezuela's opposition leader Juan Guaido defies President Nicolas Maduro's arrest threat and returns to Venezuela Monday, March 4. The opposition leader announces a new protest march for Saturday, March 9, to ramp up the pressure on Maduro. Before his arrival, U.S. Vice President Mike Pence sent a warning to Maduro to ensure Guaido's safety. In a Twitter post, Pence says any threats, violence, or intimidation against him will not be tolerated and will be met with swift response. Guaido is recognized as acting president by more than 50 countries. Venezuela is in the midst of an economic upheaval after 4 years of recession that have plunged many into poverty.